Thank you very much. Thank you, Dr. Hanin, and of course, a lot of thanks to G24 and AFI for this opportunity to participate in this interesting panel. And of course, good morning, good afternoon, and evening to everyone watching the session. Today's topic is certainly receiving a lot of attention in the media. Looking through the newspapers, we see every day countless initiatives related to sustainability. These initiatives have traditionally affected the industry or energy sectors, which seems to make a lot of sense to me, considering that we generally talk about reducing, even eliminating carbon emissions. But lately, the banking sector is appearing more than these activities in the headlines. Those headlines also extend to the central banks and supervisors, so even to monetary policy. So in a nutshell, there seems to be high expectations around green finance, which gives name to today's session. Having said that, I think that we need to be very well aware of what we can achieve with the tools that we have available. I would like to highlight two things. First, central banks, supervisors, and financial institutions are rather newcomers, rather new to the fight against climate change. And secondly, in my opinion, finance can help, can contribute to this endeavor, but it cannot be the main or only policy. Fiscal and carbon tax policies are best suited to address in a targeted way at this economy like the one produced by pollution. But of course, we need to do our part, our contribution, which can be very significant. And so the next question is, what is doing Bank of Spain? Okay, so regarding international cooperation, we actively participate in the, NGFS. As you know, it was created in late 2017 with the aim of analyzing, defining, and promoting best practices relating to the management of climate risk in the financial sector. And we also participate in all the other international groups within the remit of the ECB, ESRB, SSM, EBA, or the BCBS, the Basel Committee, of course. Naturally, as a micro and macro prudential supervisor, Bank of Spain is working on several initiatives. In this context, let me start by mentioning that last week, the Spanish Parliament finally approved our ecological transition law, which establishes an ambitious path to meet our carbon reduction objectives. Indeed, carbon neutral economy by 2050. It is obvious that the transformations derived from this law will affect bank borrowers, giving rise to opportunities, but unfortunately also impacting adversely the business model of certain sectors. Therefore, it should not come to a surprise that the supervisors will require that banks measure the risks derived from the transition process and incorporate them into their management. So first, in order to foster robust management practices, both the SSM and Bank of Spain published recently a series of expectations of the appropriate measurement and management of these risks. In addition, as macroprudential supervisor, we need to assess financial institutions' exposures to high carbon emitting activities, perform stress tests for the financial system as a whole, and define the scenarios and methodologies that serve as a guide for banks. To this end, we are developing an internal methodology on the basis of stress tests applied to the Spanish banking system every year, and are also conducting a pilot program for data collection in collaboration with the major players, the major banks in the country. And those data will be added up to the data already available in our very detailed and very rich Central Credit Register. Also, we are taking action in our role as a portfolio manager, considering environmental responsibility and sustainability criteria in the investment policy and increasing our holdings of green bonds. The environmental factor is also being incorporated into the internal ratings used to evaluate the eligibility of banks' collateral for the European Central Bank. We also contribute to raising awareness through publications, conferences, and special workshops, as well as through meetings with the industry. And apart from preaching, we are also doing our internal homework, so to speak. 2 years ago, we set up an internal function to coordinate and assess our environmental impact and to instrument measures aimed at reducing this impact. At first sight, it might not seem that the central bank's activity should have an excessive environmental impact, but I can assure you that managing the waste resulting from the destruction of cash is not a small matter. Let me very briefly conclude by referring to the final part of your question. What is still missing? There are many topics still missing, but I would like to just put a stress on only one item, and it's, in my opinion, one of the most pressing issues. And this is linked to the lack of reliable data. Modeling these risks is feasible, of course, challenging, but without the right information, it is impossible to make further headway and progress. The fact that this aspect is brought up continuously and repeatedly by practitioners and academia, I think it's a reflection of its transcendence. The good news is that there is a large number of initiatives related to transparency and information on sustainability in general. In the European context, in the EU, we may mention, for example, the directive of non-financial reporting, the register of sustainable funds, the climate benchmarks, and of course, the European taxonomy. Internationally, I believe the most prominent one is the recent initiative by the ISB Foundation to create a new board for sustainability reporting. So I will stop here. Thank you very much.